Chest pain is a physical complaint that requires immediate diagnosis, evaluation, and urgent intervention, and could be actually a life-threatening condition. The epidemiology of the chest pain, actually in USA, they found out that the chest pain is the presenting symptoms of 9 to 12% of people ages 15 years and above, especially in the ER in USA, with 1 year mortality of 5%. More than 50% of the patients are presented to the emergency facilities with unexplained chest pain. And we have to rule out coronary artery disease on those patients. The rate of presentation without chest pain was actually 19% in women and 13.7% in men. What are the causes of the chest pain? Actually, there is many causes of the chest pain, especially the acute, but we divided them into cardiac and non-cardiac. And the cardiac, we should divide them into coronary heart disease and non-coronary heart disease. And as you can see in the list, cardiac, for example, if it is coronary heart disease, like ischemic heart disease, acute coronary syndrome, chronic stable angina, and unstable angina, and myocardial infarction. Non-coronary, pericarditis, cardiac tamponade, myocarditis, etc. And the non-cardiac, it's like musculoskeletal pain, gastrointestinal diseases, etc., as you can see in the list. Actually, what is the frequency of the causes of those of the chest pain? As you can see in this pie, that it's divided into a percentage. So as you can see here, like we have around 5% of them, they come with MI, 15% unstable angina, 10% stable angina, and actually 20% esophageal diseases, 20% musculoskeletal, and 20% miscellaneous, and there is 10% undiagnosed. And the cause is not actually known. We are not going to talk about all causes of acute chest pain. We are going to talk about the main or the most important or life-threatening factors or causes, like, I mean, these six, which we call them the life-threatening causes of chest pain, like pericarditis, myocarditis, acute coronary syndrome, pneumothorax, pulmonary embolism, aortic aneurysm. And what we mean by aortic aneurysm, it's only the thoracic part, because we are talking about the chest, not the whole body. And as you know, the aorta is going into the whole body. And at last, we are going to speak about acute chest syndrome.